Hello, my dear fellow Indians and future civil servants. Welcome to LOFTYIAS. You are with me, Shubham Mehta. And in today's lecture, we are going to deal with the part 2 for the May month. So today, we are going to discuss in detail the various government schemes, policies, acts that have come up in this particular month, and also assess various reports and indexes that have been released by the civil society organizations and the various international organizations based on the India's performance. Right. So today we are going to discuss the MCQs, because our evaluation of the news that have come up in the month of May is going to be based on MCQs practice, and this would be very helpful for prelims 2018. Now this is our Facebook page, lofty.is.7. You can reach out here to obtain consolidated PDF of today's lecture. Now, why I'm presenting prelims syllabus again after yesterday is because I want that the seven topics that have been mentioned by the UPSC for its prelims examination be engraved in your mind very well, and whenever you sit down to study anything about prelims examination or whether it is mains examination, because you know that study should be very well integrated both for prelims and mains as well as the interview. So whenever you sit down to study, you should have these seven topics very well engraved in your mind. Okay, so now our plan layout is as I have mentioned it yesterday also. So yesterday I have discussed polity. Today I'm going to discuss government policies, schemes, act that have been released for the month of May. Also various organizations release their index and reports, so we will also consider them as well. For tomorrow we are going to deal with economics, so I would recommend you to come out here tomorrow as well and be prepared about the economics for the month of May. Okay, now let's come to our first question. Our first question is with regard to Pragati model. So actually the news was that Prime Minister had told all the chief secretaries of the state to advance the implementation of Mission Indradhanush, or we can say that Mission Indradhanush will last till 2018 instead of 2020 that was earlier decided. And what is Pragati model? Pragati model is basically proactive governance and timely implementation model. It actually is a interactive platform that allows grievances of a common man to be addressed, and Prime Minister interacts with the chief secretaries of the state to ensure that the policies and the programs are implemented in a righteous manner. Right, so the first statement is it is an interactive platform to resolve common man's grievances and monitoring important program. So this is a correct statement, because this is the characteristic of this particular model. Now the grievances need to be resolved within 60 days time period. So Prime Minister had given instruction to the chief secretaries of the state that this time period needs to be followed, and this is also a correct statement. It makes use of video conferencing and geospatial technology. So actually video conferencing is done to communicate between Prime Minister's office and the chief secretaries of the state, and the bureaucrats make use of geospatial technology to assess the implementation of various programs. It works between PMO and chief secretaries of the state. So when you would read about this Pragati model, you would realize that this has three tier system instead of the two tier that has been mentioned here. So it works between Prime Minister office, secretaries at the union level, and the chief secretaries of the state. So therefore 1, 2, and 3 are correct. Therefore answer is D. Now come to question 2. With respect to Mission Indradhanush, consider the following. It targets children below 2 years only. So Mission Indradhanush is actually like the Indradhanush, which has 7 colors. It also targets 7 preventable diseases, right? So it is mainly intended for children below 2 years. This is correct, but this is not intended only for them. It includes pregnant mothers as well, vaccinating pregnant mothers as well. So therefore this statement is not correct, because you need to add that pregnant mothers are also included in this program. Then immunization is provided against 7 vaccine preventable diseases including pneumonia. Definitely the vaccine is provided against 7 vaccine preventable diseases, but pneumonia is not included. So go back home and read what are those 7 preventable diseases. I will tell you few, that diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus, tuberculosis are 4. There are 3 more. Go home and read about them and write what they are in the comment section. Right, now this is also a wrong statement, because pneumonia is not included in this program. Actually this Mission Indradhanush is a program that has been encompassed under universal immunization program, and under universal immunization program you would find that pneumonia is also covered, but not under Mission Indradhanush. Now finally, the mission receives support of WHO, UNICEF and Rotary International. This is a correct statement. Now so our answer becomes 3 only. Oh, I think I've made a mistake here. It should be 3 here. Right. So answer is 3 only. Remember this, answer is 3 only. Okay. Now question 3 is, consider the following with respect to Employer State Insurance Corporation. So this is a body that takes care of the medical needs of the employees. So the first statement is, it works under the Ministry of Health. It actually does not work under the Ministry of Health. Ministry of Labour and Employment is actually responsible for its implementation. It provides option to insured person to choose two dispensary, one for self and another for family. So this is actually the news because of which I have taken this particular question, that ministry has recently given an option under ESIC to insured people to choose two dispensaries, so that whenever they are working outside their own native state, they also have the facilities for medical emergencies. Right. So this is correct statement. This is wrong because it works under Ministry of Labour and Employment. It is a statutory body. It is correct because it is actually a statutory body and established in 1948. Applicable to all the states. It is not applicable to all the states. In fact, some of the northeastern states are not covered under it. So you need to go home and read which all northeastern states are there which are not covered under this particular scheme. Okay, so what is our correct option? 2 and 3. So this becomes the correct option. With respect to Employees Provident Fund Organization, consider. Now this was again something that was mentioned in this particular news piece that I've mentioned here. Now under this, the statements are, it is a statutory body working under Ministry of Finance, because you can consider that Employees Provident Fund, when money is involved you can believe that it is working under Ministry of Finance, but it is actually not working under Ministry of Finance. It is again working under Ministry of Labour and Employment, and it is actually a statutory body. This is also correct, but applicable for establishment employing 20 or more percent. This is also correct, but Ministry of Finance, this is not correct and this statement becomes wrong. Doesn't apply to cooperatives that employ less than 50%. So this is a correct statement, that it applies only to cooperative societies employing more than 50 people. So statement 2 is correct. With respect to Quality Council of India, consider the following. So actually you would see that in the month of May, Swachhata Sarvekshan report was published. So Quality Council of India is actually the body which is responsible for presenting that report, and this is a question that was there in prelims 2017. I just wanted to give you an idea that the question was asked in prelims not because the UPSC focuses on news. In fact, they focus on the organizations and the background of the news, right? So the question was, Quality Council of India was set up jointly by Government of India and Indian industry. This is a correct statement. Chairman of Quality Council of India is appointed by the PM on the recommendation of the industry to the government. This is also correct statement. So this is a question from prelims 2017, and the answer is both. With respect to UGC, Institute of Eminence deemed to be University Regulation 2017, consider the following. So actually, institutes, the government has proposed to have institutes of eminence constructed, or you can say developed in our country, so that we could also feature in the world's, among the world's best universities, and therefore these regulations were passed. So according to these regulations, there were some guidelines that were laid down. So the first statement is, there should be a good mix of domestic and foreign students. This is correct. The faculty student ratio should not be less than 1:10. This is also correct. So see, some might feel that what should be the student faculty ratio. So they believe that 1:10 is required, not 1:12 should be there, so that teachers could pay individual attention to all the candidates that are enrolled there in those institutions. These institutions would enjoy complete academic, administrative and financial autonomy. This is also correct. And one more important thing is, under these regulations are that not only government institutions but also the private institutions can be granted this particular status, and there would be lot of benefits that would be given if they are given this particular status. But you need to go home and read more about these regulations so that you are fully prepared for that. So the answer for this particular is 1, 2, and 3. With respect to Indian inclusion exclusion report, consider the following. It is released by Center for Civil Society. So this is actually a report that takes case that takes into consideration which all people have been excluded, or which all what are the factors that the government is not paying specific attention to and needs attention of the government. So this report is released, the first statement is this report is released by Center for Civil Society. So actually this report was actually released by a civil society organization, and Center for Civil Society is also one of the very good civil society organizations. But this particular report is not published by this, but it is published by Center for Equity Studies. So this is a wrong statement. It reviews exclusion with respect to three public goods. It is not three but four, because the four public goods are pension for the elderly, digital access, agricultural land, and legal justice for under trials. This is a wrong statement. Report mentioned that Muslims, Dalits, Adivasis, elderly, and person with disability continue to be disadvantaged. So this is something that report has mentioned. So the answer is 3 only. So I think I have missed that option. So answer is going to be 3 only. Okay, just pay attention to that. Answer is going to be 3 only. This is the correct option here. Now, question number 8. With respect to Public Affairs Index, consider the following. It is an initiative of Public Affairs Center. The survey is based on 10 themes. So actually this index takes care of the various parameters like governance, physical and social infrastructure, and this was an initiative of Public Affairs Center. Definitely this is a body headquartered in Bangalore. The survey is based on 10 themes, 27 focus subjects, and 82 indicators. So read what all themes are there, right? So the this is also a correct statement, because it takes care of 10 themes, 26 focus subjects, and 22 indicators. So also correct statement. So answer is both. Now coming to 9th question, with respect to reader, there was some guidelines titled Raising Happy Children and Providing Safe Childhood. Consider the following. It was released by Ministry of Health. So actually it was not released by Ministry of Health. In fact, this was released by Ministry of Women and Child Development. So it gives guidelines to parents, teachers to protect the child from delinquent behavior. Okay. It draws upon basic principle of Juvenile Justice Act. This is also correct, because this is something that has been incorporated and taken care in that this particular title. Article 39F talks about protection of childhood against exploitation. So I have gone to the background of this particular question, and I have mentioned this particular article, so that you should go home, read, and you should pick up that constitution book and read what actually is mentioned about the protection of childhood in our constitution, and article 39 actually deals about it. So this is a correct statement. So answer is 2, 3, and 4. Now these are some of the communities that were mentioned, that were recently given some particular status in particular state. So a presidential order had to be passed for that, and that was made into an act and included into an act. So these communities have been given some particular community status, and that is of these communities are Swalgiri, Sabakhia, and Swalgiri. So these are the communities that are present in Odisha state. So they have been given the status of scheduled caste. So this is the correct option. Now 11th question is the implementation of Darwaza Band. So see, this is a very important question, because the Darwaza Band campaign is very well taken care by the media. This is in fact the organization which is overseeing its implementation. They have brought in celebrities like Amitabh Bachchan and Anushka Sharma. So when big celebrities and lot of money had to be spent on its promotion, so this becomes a very important program, and this program is implemented by not Ministry of Rural Affairs, not Ministry of Culture, not Ministry of Urban Development, but Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation. Now with respect to telecom sector, consider the following. So actually this was a scheme that was recently released by the telecom ministry. So this scheme, Sanchar Kaushal Vikas Pratishthan scheme, actually aims to train rural youth to maintain mobile towers. So This is a correct statement. The second is Tarang Sanchar portal. This is a portal that has been recently launched by the telecom ministry, and this portal is launched to allay the myths about emission from mobile towers. So this is also a correct statement. So this becomes both. Now the second 13th question is World Press Freedom Index. So on May 3 we had World Press Day, and on that particular day a particular organization releases this index. So now it consider the statements. The report blames rise in Hindu nationalism for drop in ranking of India. So actually the ranking of India got dropped from 133 to 136, and the report actually blames rise in Hindu nationalism for drop in ranking of India. It is published by Reporters Sans Frontier. So you would know that in 2016 there was a question that was asked on Medicine Sans Frontier. This is a body that prelims there was question on Medicine Sans Frontiers, but this time it's Reporters Sans Frontiers that I've asked here. So Reporters Sans Frontiers is actually the organization that releases this index. Now Reporters Sans Frontiers is a non-governmental international organization. This is a correct, and this was a particular question that was asked in prelims 2016. On that paper it was Medicine Sans Frontiers, right? So the correct options are all of the above. Now the 14th question is Sampada scheme. I would not tell you the complete full form of this particular scheme. I want you to go back home, read about it, and write what this particular scheme in the comment section. And I just took the name of this particular organization so that the question can be asked that with respect to this particular scheme which is currently in the news. So what is this particular scheme? This scheme is something related to processing industries, and the scheme will be an umbrella scheme incorporating ongoing schemes of not Ministry of Women and Child Development, not Ministry of Health. Because when you see Sampada, you can think about various options, but the correct option is Ministry of Food and Processing Industry. It actually it is an umbrella scheme that is going to incorporate ongoing schemes like Mega Food Pass scheme, cold chain schemes, and these are all going to be incorporated under this Sampada scheme. This is going to generate a lot of employment, generate a lot of revenue, and help farmers in doubling their income. So this is a very important scheme. With respect to National Health Policy, consider the following. So National Health Policy 2017 was recently approved by the Union Cabinet, and with respect to that you have to consider the following statements. The policy proposes raising public health expenditure to 2.5% of the GDP in a time-bound manner. So actually this is something that was mentioned in the policy. It envisages private sector collaboration for strategic purchasing and capacity building. So you might think whether private sector has been involved by the government or not, but actually they have envisaged this particular thing also, a move from treatment based to prevention based approach. Because earlier we only spent money in creating hospitals, tertiary and secondary hospitals, but now we have planned that instead of spending a lot of money on treatment, we'll take care from the prevention state itself. So this is also correct. Now fourth statement is better access to Ayush remedies through co-location in public facilities. So go write down in the comment section what Ayush actually is, and it is also correct that they have decided for this particular objective also. So the answer is all of the above. 16th question is Rashtriya Swasthya Bhima Yojana. Consider the following with respect to this particular Yojana. This publicly funded health insurance scheme is available for all citizens of India. Actually, this is not available for all the citizens of India. This actually scheme was launched in 2009, and this is available not for all the citizens but families below poverty line only. So this is a wrong statement. The scheme is run by Ministry of Labour and Employment. Earlier when the scheme was launched, it was run by Ministry of Labour and Employment, but now it is not run by this particular organization but run by Ministry of Health and Family Affairs. Question 17 is with respect to International Standard Book Number. Why I've asked this particular question is because you would see that in prelims 2017 there was a question on Bureau of Indian Standards and also about ECMA. So these are some of the questions that are also asked these days. So you need to take care of all the important things that are coming in the news, right? So the statements are, it is a 12 digit unique number like Aadhaar written at the back of the book. It is actually you must have seen that there are some black lines that are given at the back of the book, and here it is written ISBN, and then you would have the complete number written over here and also here. So this is written at the back of the book, but this is not a 12 digit number. In fact, this is a 13 digit number. Okay, and it is mandatory for publishing the books. No, it is not mandatory for publishing the books. Okay, now Raja Ram Mohan Roy National Agency under HRD oversees its allotment. So this is correct that HRD had given the responsibility to Raja Ram Mohan Roy National Agency for allotting ISBN number to books that come for to it. Right, so the only correct option is 3 only. Okay, 3 only. Here again I have made a mistake, not mentioned it. Now 18 is, consider the following statements. The Parliamentary Committee on Official Language recommended to make Hindi compulsory in all CBSC schools till class 10th. So Parliamentary Committee had released a report in which they had actually mentioned this. Why have they taken this particular question is because there were anti-Hindi protest in Karnataka. There always remains anti-Hindi protest in Tamil Nadu state, and some of the state where Hindi is not their second language other than English. So that's why I've taken this particular question. This is a correct statement. Now Article 341 stipulates the use of English in the Supreme Court and High Court. I want that you go home and read Article 343 till 351, which talk about the official language of our union, then official language of the High Court, etc. So you go back home and read from 343 to 351. Right, now this statement is also correct. Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and UP have been given the right to use Hindi in their high courts. This is correct statement. The same right has been given to Tamil Nadu and Gujarat and Chhattisgarh. This is incorrect statement, because although these states have Hindi as their second language and they have been given the right, but these states have not been given the right to use either Tamil or Gujarati as their court language. So this is a wrong statement. Answer is 1, 2 and 3. Question 19 is with respect to Medical Council of India. Those are statements are, clause 1.5 of its regulation requires doctors to prescribe generic medicines. So there have always been debates whether doctors should prescribe general medicines only or not, and whether branded are more better than the generic medicines. So there have always been debate about this. So this is the correct statement, that clause 1.5 of its regulation actually mentions about prescribing generic medicines to the patients. And the second statement is, bioavailability of generic and medicine, branded and generic medicines is same. So you would see that actually bioavailability of these two different medicines, like generic and branded medicines, is not same. Had they been same, then why would they produce two different medicines? So actually bioavailability is the rate at which the active ingredients of a medicine act at the site of a problem, at the site of action of drug, right? So this is generally not, many times it might be same, but generally it is not same for both of these. So this is not a correct statement. And had this been same, so why would they produce two different medicines, right? They should have produced only a single medicine for a particular disease, or for with particular ingredients, right? So this is different. The answer is one only. With respect to healthcare access and quality ranking that was recently published by Institute for Healthcare Metrics and Evaluation in the Lancet magazine. So these rankings have spoken about global burden of disease, and this study had been undertaken by Institute for Healthcare Metrics and Evaluation in association with Washington University and various other organizations and individuals spread throughout the world, working in those universities. So this is the correct statement. And the healthcare access quality index is based on death rates from 32 ailments that could be avoided by timely medical intervention. So actually this talks about the various diseases, and these ailments are 32 in number that they actually discuss about and evaluate. So this is also correct statement. So answer becomes both. Now 21 is with respect to Vidya Virta Abhiyan. Consider, so this is a scheme that has been launched recently, and with respect to this, it was launched by Ministry of Defense. So actually it is not released by Ministry of Defense, it is actually released by Ministry of HRD. Why I have given this particular option is because when you actually this the aim of this scheme is to encourage university to display portraits of Paramvir Chakra decorated soldiers. So this is correct. But when you would read that Paramvir Chakra decorated soldiers have to be displayed in the university, so you might feel that this is launched by Ministry of Defense. But actually this is not launched by Ministry of Defense. This was launched by Ministry of HRD. Okay, so this was launched by Ministry of HRD. And third statement is Kirti Chakra is the highest military decoration award. Actually, Kirti Chakra is not the highest, but Paramvir Chakra is the highest military decoration award. And this year it was not given to anybody. Instead, Kirti Chakra were given to many. Like it, Paramvir Chakra, it refers to Paramvir Chakra can be awarded only once. So actually, Paramvir Chakra can be awarded twice. So this is not a correct statement. It can be awarded twice, but has not been given twice to anybody until now. So the correct statement is two only. Question 22 is with respect to technology and innovation support centers. So actually these centers have been established recently by DIPP, that is Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion under Ministry of Commerce, and WIPO, that is World Intellectual Property Organization. They both have signed an MOU to establish these organizations. So what is the aim of this particular organization? Support center assist innovators in developing countries, like the startups you can say, that come up with new innovations to manage their intellectual property rights, right? So this is basically the function of this support centers. And Cell for IPR Promotion and Media is the nodal agency for setting up these centers. This is also a correct statement. And this particular body is responsible for implementation of IPR policy that was released in 2016. So all of the above is the correct answer. Now, with respect to Seva app, consider the following. Seva app was launched by Ministry of Power. So this is a correct. So the full form is what? You have to write down what is the full form of Seva in the comment section below. I want to know how you are reacting, or whether you are also engaged in the learning process or not. So write down the full form of this particular Seva app in the comment section below. So whether it was launched by Ministry of Power, definitely it was launched by Ministry of Power. This was developed by Coal India Limited. This is also true. This will increase the consumer connect in LPG cylinders distribution. So actually this was meant for coal. This is going to increase the consumer connect, but with respect to coal distribution, right? So this is for coal distribution. So answer is 1 and 2 only. E-Krishi Samvad is a way for PM to connect with E-Krishi Samvad. Now you have to look what this is. For PM to connect, when you see Krishi, you would know that this refers to farmer. Samvad means dialogue. Then what does this mean, dialogue with farmers? For PM to connect with farmers through radio broadcast? No. Toll-free numbers to resolve queries of farmers? No. Internet-based interface to provide direct and effective solutions to the problems faced by the farmer and stakeholders in the agriculture sector. This is the answer. And even live broadcast of professors from agriculture universities suggesting towards improving farm yield. This is also not the correct thing, though this is the answer. 25. Electricity accessibility ranking was recently in the news published by. So these are the rankings like how many households in a country are having access to electricity. This is the ranking that was recently in the news published by UNDP. UNDP is United Nations Development Program. So did it release this particular ranking to see how improved the governance of a nation is, how well they are developing? No. Where the environment program? No. Where the international agency for atomic energy agency had released this. International Atomic Energy Agency had released this. Even in fact, this had also not released. Although this particular organization sees whether the countries are using nuclear power only for war purposes or for producing electricity through rightful means. So in fact, even this particular organization is not responsible for that, for releasing these rankings. World Bank had released these rankings. So you would see that these days the UP is asking that this particular report is released by which organization. So that's why I've included this particular question as well. So I think we are done with today's lecture. And now I want that you go to our Facebook page and take a consolidated PDF so that you could mark the important questions which you feel are very good or were a new learning for you for your later consideration, and come back tomorrow here and come prepared with the economics for the month of May, and we will discuss about the MCQs from economics for the month of May. Okay, so until then, goodbye, have a nice day, bye bye.